Most beef producers rely on harvested forage as a primary feed resource during at least part of the winter feeding period, and when dry weather during the growing season reduces pasture growth. In this edition of Beef Tips, we're going to focus on timing of hay harvest. I'm Dr. Ron Luminager, Beef Extension Specialist in the Department of Animal Science at Purdue University.
And I'm Dr. Keith Johnson. I am Purdue University's Forage Extension Specialist.
Keith, let's begin this discussion talking about when should we harvest a hay crop to both optimize quality and quantity in a beef cattle enterprise.
Well, as I see it, grasses like tall fescue, orchard grass, and timothy should be harvested for the first time shortly after the grasses begin to head and before pollen shed happens. Thereafter, grasses will be harvested on about a 6-week interval. Alfalfa, a common legume, should be cut when the flower buds are fully formed and beginning to bloom. Red clover, another common legume, should be harvested before a third of the flower heads are in bloom. Flower formation in the spring at first harvest is not as good an indicator of when to harvest. Rather, we should be looking at the presence of crown buds as a better indicator. Grass legume mixtures should be complementary with one another. So we look at alfalfa and red clover really working well in a combination with later to mature orchard grass or a low endophyte or novel endophyte tall fescue. And harvest is dictated by the legume component of that mixture.
So, Keith, what's your recommendations for proper harvest moisture content of different types of hay packages?
Well, certainly bale density and the size of bale dictates the right targeted safe moisture level to begin baling. Small square bales should be less than 20% moisture, big round bales less than 18%, and big square should be in the neighborhood of 16 or 17% moisture. What happens with moisture above those levels is they promote microorganism growth that can result in excessive heating within the bale. And in storage, the internal bale temperature should be less than 125 degrees Fahrenheit, but higher temperatures should be carefully monitored, because high internal bale temperature can bind some of the protein to fiber, making some of it undigestible, produce molds, which further reduces the quality of the hay, and then we can possibly look at fire being a real concern with excessive heat. If harvested too dry, so we get down to less than 15% moisture, we're going to find that we can have extreme leaf loss occur. And this is particularly an issue with legumes where the leaves are the highest quality portion of the plant. I won't get into details today, but there are moisture probes that can be purchased, and procedures using forced heated air, small ovens, microwave ovens, or vortex dryers made with a hair dryer that can be used to determine hay moisture content.
You know, Keith, unfortunately, Mother Nature plays a role in whether or not we can make a timely harvest of hay. Let's talk a little bit about how weather can impact hay harvest and ultimately hay quality, and especially with that first cutting.
Well, certainly Mother Nature does have many personalities, and one needs to make sure that there are at least 3 consecutive predicted days of no rain to make top quality hay. We do want to make hay when the sun does shine. One cannot be successful in making quality hay only on the weekend. Delaying harvest beyond the targeted plant stage does result in less protein, it results in more fiber, and that excess fiber results in less digestibility and a lesser dry matter intake by the consuming beef animal. Higher humidity does lengthen the time to dry down to a safe baling moisture, and we want to make sure, if possible, that the soil is not really wet, because a wet soil is going to delay the dry down process. And wheel tracks that can occur with wet soils can hurt plant crowns, and this affects the regrowth and productivity of the next crop. Rained on hay in the swath or the windrow leaches soluble nutrients into the soil, and this is going to reduce digestibility. The extent of this damage depends on how much rain falls, the number of days before sunshine returns, and where the hay was in terms of its dry down moisture content when the rain fell.
You know, Keith, you know, you mentioned about this leaching and that kind of thing. And, you know, there are times that, you know, you've watched the weather forecast, you've, you know, you think you've got that 3 or 4 day window to get dry hay. you're almost there, you're 2 or 3 hours away from that hay hitting your target moisture content, and the storm clouds are brewing in the west, and you have to make the decision, am I going to pull the trigger and am I going to start baling hay when it's a little bit too wet, or do I go ahead and just wait it out and hope that the rain doesn't fall too hard, too long, and that the sunshine comes back soon? What do you do in that situation?
Well, there are consequences that actually can happen if you do harvest that hay. And really what I would suggest happen is that we have a propionic acid, acetic acid, preservative applicator mounted on that baler and be willing to invest in the cost of the preservative to keep the hay from developing microorganisms that creates the heat and the molds.
In summary, the key take-home points are harvest at the correct stage of plant maturity to optimize forage quality, and baling at the correct moisture content to minimize heating or in storage losses.